Now look for number 10. You're going to see it in a second. I'm going to freeze this because Tomas is on the weak side where that miss is probably going to go, not boxing. Q is not boxing. And LT, number 15, is completely out of position on number 10, who's just on the inside. Shot goes up. There's number 10. There he is again. There he is again. No one's getting position on him. And then let's see what happens at the other end. And keep an eye on number 10, big guy. How are you going to stop number 10? Watch what he does on the shot. There's an accidental elbow by L, and then an intentional elbow by number 13. You always want a guy like number 10 on your team, because when you have to play against him, you have your work cut out for you. The most common box out mistake is no boxing out. So watch, the shot's going to go up. And there's no mental discipline here of finding a body and boxing out first. You're going to see here Tomas do an outstanding job of boxing out. And then you're going to watch the same clip again to see how one person who's out of position can take away all this hard work by Tomas. Another common mistake is getting pushed too far under the basket, which is a really smart move offensively. So watch Goodell battle with number 11, who does a smart thing and bumps her under the basket. So the only rebound Goodell is going to get is the one that goes in the hoop, and that one doesn't count. The tough part is here is what we're supposed to be doing, which Coach Malcolm is showing, and that you're supposed to be in good help defense, which puts you right under the basket. The problem is you then have to create space. And most kids follow the ball. They see the ball go up. So there goes Delilah. Watch on the weak side how Chris, who is a whole 2 feet shorter than Yannicka, goes toward the ball and gets under the basket. If that shot goes long, Yannicka has a clear offensive rebound and putback. Another common mistake. Maggie's going to call this a push by Willie. I'm going to call it a wimpy box out. Maggie does a slightly tougher job in the next clip, and then Goodell does the whiff in boxing out Malik. And then Malik shows a common problem, which is called leading with the butt. You don't want to lead with the butt. Here's why. First, it helps a ton to hear the person on the ball call shot. That gives Justin over here plenty of time to box out and create space to push Jane out of position, and for him to secure this rebound. We don't expect it much from fifth and sixth graders. I mean, I could be screaming it right into the basket, and the kid can be nodding her head, and she still won't box out. But seventh and eighth graders can form the mental habit that every time they hear shot, they think position the way Heath does here. Heath's a good head shorter than Yannicka, but he creates enough space and has good enough hands to bring in that rebound and then go on the attack. Now, what's demonstrated here is how you create space. So both Willie and Malcolm have bumped and created space to then box out, whereas Malik has gone too heavy at Zach and he loses his footing. So watch in the slow motion how he's got the wrong foot forward and he doesn't drop step. So he should kind of bump with the forearm right now with a bump, and then he should spin with his left foot and drop step. He spins with the wrong footwork and Zach finds the gap. Willie's footwork is correct, and he boxes Katie right out of bounds. The use of your forearms has to come a little earlier. So Tomas should have probably bumped with a forearm and locked his elbows kind of on the guy's hips and flipped his hands up. A lot of rebounds are missed because kids have their hands tangled, you know, underneath the hips instead of raised up at their chest. So you'll see the same habit here on a fast break situation with Max, who's going to be on number 12, and he'll turn. And also with Zach, and then I'm thrilled that they're boxed out, but their hands are down. So it's not bad hands. Maybe it's more bad hand position, where Tomas has to flip his hands up earlier to be able to grab this board with two hands. And that's what is impressive about number 10. He has no one on him here, but he is in box out form, and he's already flipped his hands up. And it's always a nice bonus when you have hands like this. And it's not over on the rebound. The common mistake kids make is after working this hard for a rebound, the point guard, who's Maggie here, takes off down the sideline instead of securing the ball. It's really important that you secure your defensive set here the way Heath does in the box out and the way Ben does in the pursuit of the ball. And then Heath gets it, and Marshall doesn't go flying down the court. It's not ideal that he's on the far side, but he steps back to make sure Heath can find him and they can go on the attack. So the mistake here is 11 isn't guarded on this reversal. There's a double team. But what the upside is you got Maggie boxing, Jane boxing, Ashley, and Delilah boxing. Maggie gets awesome position for this rip, and then everyone turns and goes on the attack. Now for the final secret about rebounding and about defense in general. Tall, short, fast or slow, if you want the ball more than the person next to you, you're much more likely to get it.